Well, hello. Nice to meet you.
Me too.
How are you doing?
I'm very good. How are you?
I am good, thanks. I absolutely adore Abominable as a film. So I was so excited when you guys came out with a series. So I would love to know just what was your reaction when you found out you were going to return to this world as Jin?
Oh, so excited. Just pure, pure excitement. I love playing this character so much. It's always so much fun to do it. Like every single scene, all the way down, every single line is so much fun just playing this character. So all I can say is I was just full of excitement.
He's such a fun character too. I mean, the whole movie makes me smile, but I mean, Jin has such a nice arc over the course of it. Like, is the series going to continue to build on his character like that?
Oh, 100%. I think that you can even say that he learns more about himself and builds his character more in the show than he does the movie. I can speak for his character and the relationships with the other characters as well. I would say that they grow more in the television show than the movie.
What's it like voicing a character like this? And, you know, a character who's got so many different sides. Like he's got a big ego, but he's also got a big heart. And it just seems like there's a lot of opportunity in there.
It's really fun as an actor, especially. I can say that me and Jin relate as people or characters in a lot of senses. So it's not that hard because I can also pull from my own life and my own emotions in playing him. But as an actor, it's a lot of fun because, you know, like you said, he goes through a lot of character building. So it's really fun to play.
Do you have a favorite thing about Jin?
His obsession with shoes, 100%. I am a huge shoe person myself, so that's one of the things we relate on. But his obsession with shoes, I can 100% relate to. So
was that just a happy accident? You both happened to be really.
Yeah, it was. I remember reading the very first scene when he like jumps in the mud and it gets all over his shoes, and he's like, "Oh, my shoes!" I was like, "That's me. That's not Jin. That is Tenzing."
That's so awesome. Well, what about his friendship with E? I mean, they had a bit of a rough patch, but they've been through so much together. You know, what do you like most about their dynamic?
I think that it's a real brother and sister dynamic. I have two younger brothers myself, so I never got to experience life with a sister, but playing this character has been so much fun. Like, because they butt heads all the time, but I think through the show, you see that they start to appreciate one another because they both bring something different to the table in their journeys and the issues that they have to resolve with these magical creatures. So, I think that it's a lot of fun more getting to play that brother and sister sort of side of things.
Well, the series is about E and the gang, you know, helping these creatures like they did for Everest. I'm taking a consensus with the cast. Do you have a favorite magical animal this season?
they're all great. They are all so cool. I remember going through each episode hearing about I was excited to come in and hear about what the new creature was going to be, you know, like what could his name be? What could his powers be? It could be literally anything, but I would have to say it goes along with one of my favorite episodes is, Morty, the one that licks and makes things invisible. That one has to be one of my favorites because it's also one of my favorite episodes because it really makes Jin look like a fool. But so I'll probably have to say Morty.
That's awesome. Cool. Well, I know Jin isn't the biggest fan of this, but if Everest offered to use his cloud magic, would you go for a ride and where would you go?
See, that's where we differ because I would 100% do it. Actually, you know what? Now I'm thinking about it. I say that now, but I feel like when the time comes, I would probably check it out. But
I feel the same.
Yeah. But if I were to do it, I would go to, I would go to China. Honestly, I've never been to China myself, and I would love to see all the beautiful places that we went to in the film that aren't really the big, you know, tourist destinations, like the big cities. They're kind of the more nature sort of things, and I've never been. So I would say that.
Wow, awesome. Well, lastly, I just wanted to ask, you know, I know that this was a voice acting role. You've also done live action. Do you have a preference between, you know, which you like to do more?
I really don't. I'm so happy that I got to experience this film and the show, because it's like the first major sort of voice acting thing I've done. And after doing it, I can say that I don't really have a preference. They're both super fun. They both have their perks and they both are difficult in certain ways, and they're both fun in certain ways. But I love both, and I'm grateful to do both.
Do you notice a big difference between the two at all? Or, you know, is it a pretty similar approach?
You know, surprisingly, voice acting is tiring. Like it pulls a lot out of you, because when you're doing these things on camera, you're sort of actually doing these actions. Like, I'm actually running, I'm actually driving, I'm actually, you know, doing all these things. But when you're voice acting, you're just standing there. And you sort of have to build all this energy just from being in a straight position. And I know me personally, as an actor, I like to act everything out as if I'm doing it. I don't like to just stand there and that's it. So I get in trouble a lot, actually. They're like, you're moving too much. I'm like, I'm sorry. But yeah, so that's one thing that I would say is surprising about voice acting.
So cool. Yeah, I never would have thought that. Like, I would have thought it would be the opposite. Yeah, that's so cool. Awesome. Well, that is all I have for you today. Thanks so much for chatting with me.
Of course. Thank you for having me.
Awesome.